What's good, everybody in Chicago? Kahlief here, Pax West 2019. I am here with one of the best people in the industry, one of my favorite folks of all time, the man, the myth, the legend. It is Pat Baer. What is good, Pat?
I mean, it's Sunday. It's Sunday, right?
It's kind of Sunday.
Okay, it's Sunday. It's day 3 of 7 here at PAX. That's my terrible joke, but really, yeah, it's only day 3. And I'm excited because I got, like, you know, I'm going to go maybe play some games today.
Did you see I can't even talk. Yeah. You see any cool stuff yet that you already are thinking about and stuff you're already digging?
So I spent a lot of time at Tabletop, and I played a bunch of unreleased games, that some of which were like, please don't tweet about this game. And I was like, that sounds pretty cool. But I think if you're at PAX, if you're watching this and you're like gonna go to PAX, going to the free play area of Tabletop is totally worth it, because those games are like, sometimes those games are $100 and you can just hand over your license and borrow it and play it with your friends.
I didn't know that was a thing.
Yeah, they got a lending library, and it's like, honestly, especially like PAX East or PAX South, it is the best thing at that convention. Here, I mean, you got the big games, right? I also waited in line and then chickened out, and I didn't lay in that coffin at Tiny Builds.
I was just talking about that earlier with Evan, and I was like, I really should have just sat in the coffin and gotten some footage of it. But I also walked through that spot, and it was wet as fuck, and almost fell and bust my ass.
Yeah, no. I mean, look, I hate it and appreciate the fact that they were like, well, it's a dungeon, so lay in this coffin and hold the switch, and then we'll also have a fog machine. And as someone who has had some issues with fog here at PAX West, they did their due diligence, apparently. And also, there's a bigger space than a hotel ballroom, but, like, I'm kind of just mad about it still.
The year that the fog machine died, it was that year. I remember that year. I was there that year. We just talked about that a little bit earlier today. Shout out to Greg Miller and the fog machine. I also don't like the fact they had a whole bunch of kids in those coffins. That was super weird.
Yeah, I mean, there's never a good time for a kid to crawl into a coffin, but this week, it's not great.
Especially not great. We're going to turn to actually fun things to talk about. One of the best things about the shows that you do and the shows you go to is that you always bring so much fun to everywhere you go. League of Heels stuff is always phenomenal. Always been super excited to be a part of that stuff. I was able to be in your 404 panel this year. Thank you again for having me. It was fantastic. Tell the folks at home about the panel and how much fun it was.
So 404ing it is, I love the internet. I started a Tumblr, you know, when Tumblr was still a thing, about my favorite stuff on the internet, and I decided that should be a show. And then at PAX, it doesn't have to be about video games at PAX. It just could be about community and positivity. So I invite my friends who are fun, that, you know, spend a lot of time on the internet, to like bring the things they love. And then it's an escape for people. My big goal with PAX is to do comedy panels where there's effort put into them, and it's not just like, hey, I love a live podcast recording, or I love like an industry panel. Like, I think those are really beneficial, but there's definitely room for like an improv panel or a funny video panel, like something for people to just like have a great memory coming out of PAX. That's like my goal with all of it. And I was so happy you got to do it. Like, anytime you're in League of Heels, you know, when I'm West Coast, it's like, oh, okay. Who can I get that isn't at every PAX when I'm at one particular PAX? I always try to book the people that only do that PAX.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, me being able to do my Kaka Beware skit, my thing is just always fun. I get to do it. I keep thinking about better ways to make it better. It means more birds, and it means more costume stuff. It means more flair. But I just never get the chance to bring it in my damn suitcase when I get here. So I'm like, I need to remember next time to bring that stuff. But, yeah, you always kill it with all the panels you do. It's always amazingly fun. What are some of the last things you're going to check out before you boogie up out of PAX this year?
So I'm going to take my time on the 6th floor. I think for those who haven't been to PAX West, there's two conventions that are like expo halls. There's the 4th floor and the 6th floor. And the 6th floor is where you're going to find, like, Ukrainian games, or, like, Poland showed up and brought like 9 games all by Polish devs, and they're all together because they pool their resources. And just stuff that, like, you're going to play games that aren't going to come out. Just honestly will never come out, and you might be the only of your friends that ever gets to play it. So that's where I'm going to take my time. There's a cyberpunk bar game that, like, the art just looks awesome, and it's like an adventure game. And I was like, yeah, I'm going to play that tomorrow.
Yeah. The Polish crew is actually really, really dope. They always put out some, like, super funky stuff, but it always leaves you with, like, oh, I really want that to be something that dropped.
Yeah. I mean, I think that's the best part of PAX, are those hidden gems. Those, like, yeah, you can wait in line a really long time, and play whatever Nintendo is going to be putting out this year or next year. And have a great time. And do that. If that's your thing, if you want to wait in line for 2 hours to buy merch from Bungie, just merch. You want to wait 2 hours for merch, do that. That's your PAX. But I've been doing enough of them that I want to go to the indie mini booth on Monday and play a game with a developer who's like, I hope this build doesn't crash.
That is definitely most of the stuff that's at the mega booth sometimes. It's like, it may crash, it may not crash, and when it doesn't crash, it's usually phenomenal and amazing. Shout out to mega booth folks, by the way. Pat, I love you. Thank you for coming and hanging out with us, man. So good to see you. I'll see you in a bit.
Hell yeah. I'll see you soon.
Oh, you got to plug your stuff.
Okay, twitch.tv/PatBaer, PatBaer. It's the German spelling. Twitch and Twitter and anywhere on the internet, YouTube. I put up fun stuff. And if you like model kit building and you didn't know that was something that people did on Twitch, that's what I do.
Fantastic stuff. Make sure you're checking out Pat's stuff. We're going to be back in a little bit. PAX 2019. Peace.